Hey guys, today I'm going to be working on my Macintosh Plus keyboard. I just want to show you which model. So this is a M0110A. It's made in the USA, which indicates that it's one of the earlier models. And the D indicates that it's a German layout. So I've already taken out some caps. Because when I plug it into my Macintosh, only half of the keys are working. I've marked the ones that are working with a black pencil, and everything that is white appears to be not working. So that's quite a lot of keys. I just left a couple here to show you how to get rid of the keys, and they basically are just stuck on here, so you have to pull it off. I just wanted to show you how easy this actually is. And so in order they don't get lost, I have them here. This is some sticky surface so they don't get lost. And they stay in order because otherwise you won't remember where they're going, or you need the reference keyboard to check. So, that means I actually have to check what's wrong, whether it's the keys or the board itself. This is the solder side of the keyboard. And what I'm gonna do now is check if the circuit closes when I activate one particular key. So I've marked numbers 8 and 9, as you can see, because I'm going to check them. When I look on the other side, these are the middle ones here, and the 8 appears to be working. That's the one with the black indicator here, while 9 is not. So I'm going to try that out with a multimeter. Here we have the multimeter. It's a very basic one. You need to put it in the right position in order to measure things. So I'm just gonna set it to ohms because that's the resistance it's supposed to have. I have no idea what kind of measurements are right or wrong. I just figured if there is some sort of resistance, then the key should be working. I've set it to the lowest possible value now. So let me put this here. So now we're checking if we actually, when we connect that. Okay, so it appears to be working. We have now a resistance of 0.5 ohms. And what I'm doing now is I'm checking number 9. So I need to simultaneously push the key. Okay, there is nothing. Number 8. Okay, there is a resistance. So that actually means, I'm just going to check another one. So that actually means that it's probably the key and not the board that has the problem, which means I'm gonna have to desolder the keys. In order to know what I need to desolder and what not, I've marked these with a small black dot. So these two appear to have a resistance and these two are not, which means I'm gonna desolder them and see if I can make them work. Now, for basic soldering techniques, there are two ways. So here I have the soldering iron. It's already heated. It's set to 350 degrees Celsius, which means some 700 degrees Fahrenheit. In case you're from the US, so now we have this desoldering pump. That's one way to desolder it, which means I'm gonna activate the suction. Then I'm gonna make it liquid and put it away. And you can see It worked. So the solder is gone. The second technique would be taking the solder wick. It's basically some copper wire which you put on there, and then you heat it up, and the wire is actually gonna suck it up. So here you see the wire is sucking in the solder. As you can see, working with the solder wire is a bit more working with the wick is a bit more tricky and takes a bit more patience, but it's more precise than the pump. Anyways, let's try it once more with the pump. Let's check and see if these are moving. I'll take this little fella here and see if we freed up. Okay, this one is loose and this one is not. Let's do it one more time. Time with the wick, and there we go, it's loose. Okay. So, as you can see, both are moving. So I'm gonna turn around. Now this was the second key, this one here. Now there is this snap mechanism, which means you have to push these things together and then just pull the key out. And that's basically how you desolder a key. Now the problem is, in general, when you need to repair something on the board, like these transistors here, or well, I guess this one, the chip, you can get out like this. But if you need to get to the board, you need to desolder all the keys, because they are actually the ones holding this black plate in place. It's not only screwed, but it's also held back by the keys. So you would need to remove every single key in order to get to the board. So I'm quite happy that it's not the board. So in order to get this mechanism out of the plastic, I need to get rid of the residue solder, which is below here on the pins, because otherwise I can't get it through the plastic. So be careful when you're doing that, like this, not to burn yourself. I'm just gonna try and see if I will manage to get rid solder. Now, as you see, there is still some on there. Let's try it like that. Good. So I think we can push it through, because then it will be much more easier to check. Alright, there it is. So that's the mechanism that doesn't seem to work. I'm gonna hold it like this so you can better see it. Let's figure out. Just need to refocus the camera. So let's again take the multimeter. is no resistance. It's open. And then you close the plate. And there is resistance. So that means basically we just need to bend the plate. We need to bend the plate in the right way and hope that we will make it work again. So what I'll be doing is I will take off the small metal plate here and bend it, because that's supposed to be the one that's the mechanism. Oh, come on. All right. So we have it here. That's apparently the one that is causing us troubles. So let's bend it a bit inwards so it's a bit more tighter. And then let's just put it back onto this mechanism. Okay, I'm gonna do this by hand because I think it's more easier. I'm just gonna push it back on. Okay. And now I'm gonna reassemble the key and see if it changed anything. Here we are again. I reassembled it. It didn't work, so I disassembled it again. This is gonna be a bit of sort of a trial and error thing. So I'm now trying a different thing. I'm trying to bend these arms so that the plastic mechanism pushing them down has a bit more traction. So I'm just gonna very delicately bend them upwards a bit more. And see if this was the problem. Yep, that was it. So as you can see, I reassembled the mechanism. It also feels a lot more tighter. And I'm gonna test it now with the multimeter. So I'm gonna connect it down. Then I'm gonna, was not connected. And I'm gonna push the button. And as you can see, there is resistance going on, which means that it should be working again. To reinsert it, you just snap it back in place. It's fairly easy, there's not much to it. Then we turn it back to the solder side, and I'm gonna show you how to reapply the solder to close the solder joint. So I'll have some solder wire, which is this piece, and I'm gonna heat it again with the soldering iron. So yeah, it melts, and I'm just gonna apply it here. All right. Now, just one last thing to mention. This is about the second time I'm soldering, so I'm actually using the soldering iron. I never did it before I started working on these Macintosh computers, so it's fairly easy to get around. Just use some board you don't care about to, you know, try a bit the technique, desolder something, and then solder something back. Okay, so I hooked up my Macintosh Plus. I've booted it with the system disk 3.2 because I actually like that one better to check things like the keycaps, because it has a program called keycaps, And as you can see, if I activate now, one of the keys that is working, the one I marked with black, it also shows on the screen if it's reacting. Now, let's take a white one, for example. That does nothing. And for a check, we've desoldered, repaired, and resoldered this key. And it's working. All right. That actually means I can mark this one. And in order to get the keyboard working, I only need to repeat this process I've just shown you about 45 more times. Yay! I hope you liked this video. Leave me some comments or questions if you have any. And please subscribe to my channel in order to stay updated. As I mentioned, I will try to post a new video every week. Take care.